Misty Lucas of Vicara Yoga, and welcome. I'm so happy you could join me today, and I'm happy that you found this video by reading my blog. I wrote that blog because I have a lot of students that come into class or private students that really, I hear so often, oh, I can't do yoga. I'm not flexible enough. I can't get onto the floor. I can't do this, I can't do that. And I love to share with people that, yep, you can do yoga. You can do it. And showing them the different ways to do yoga. And one of my favorite ways of teaching is to share yoga in a chair. So as you can see, I'm sitting in my chair and I just thought, you know, I did this blog and sometimes it's hard to really maybe see what is she talking about, how can we do that? So I wanted to just create a little video that maybe you could use to do some of the movements in your own home on a chair so that you could just start to experience some yoga. So as you can see, I'm in my chair. I've also got my feet on blocks. Not that I don't have the ability to bring them all the way down, but sometimes I like to just have my feet a little elevated. It feels a little better. And definitely if your legs are not long enough to touch the floor, you're gonna want something just underneath your feet to support you. And as you can see, I'm sitting in my chair, but I'm finding some alignment in my body. So I've got my knees over my ankles. I'm able to have my feet touch, firmly touch. I'm just gonna kind of rock side to side so that I can feel my sits bones and really finding that length in my spine. And I'm just allowing my shoulders to soften. So I'm just finding this comfortable seat in the chair, and really all I want to do in this moment is take a couple of breaths. I'm just going to soften my gaze and take a nice breath in through the nose and exhale through the nose. And as I'm breathing in, I'm feeling that length coming in my spine. And I'm just feeling myself reach through the crown of my head, and as I'm exhaling, I really feel my body just starting to let go and root into the chair. So just allowing yourself to connect to your body, feel yourself in the chair, feeling your breath. And then I just like to bring my arms down to my side so I can just move my shoulders through a nice range of motion. So just like inhale, rise up. So reaching up, shoulders drawing down, activating my core. So my core is nice and engaged, and then I'm gonna exhale, release my arms, and just bring the shoulders back into extension. So inhale, I'm bringing the shoulders up into flexion. Shoulders are gently drawing down my back. So this is like a seated extended mountain. Exhale, gently release back into mountain. So Tadasana. And Uddita Tadasana. So just allowing us to be in our chair. So I've got my core engaged, my shoulders softened down my back, reaching through the crown of my head. And I'm also bringing my shoulders into flexion. And then as they come back, I draw them a little bit behind me into extension. Just bringing my shoulders back down, giving them a little roll, noticing how your shoulders are feeling. And then inhale, taking the arms out to the side. So bringing them out into abduction and then adding them back in using adduction of the shoulders. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, coming back down. I'm just doing this like three times. Three's like a magic number for me. Inhale, coming out into abduction. Exhale, coming back to adduction. Beautiful. And just let your shoulders have a nice little roll back and gently rolling forward. So just really bringing movement into the body, nice and slow. And then just allowing, we hold so much tension in our necks, so much. And so I just invite you, allow your hands to come onto your lap and just notice going side to side, just turning your head gently. And maybe you also notice when you have a lot of neck stuff going on. So this is just, oh, let's see how my neck is this morning. Going gently side to side. And then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna do some nice neck stretches. I'm gonna inhale to lengthen. And then I'm gonna exhale. I'm just gonna release my right hand. So I'm feeling that stretch on my right side. And I'm just gonna take a nice deep breath. And as I exhale, see if I can just let my shoulder go. Just let it be heavy. Taking another breath in. And then I'm gonna just gently see if I can draw my shoulder blade down, noticing how that's feeling and any sensation coming in, then gently lift the head. One more breath. Just feeling that release in the side of the neck, feeling that kind of tingling coming through the arm maybe. And then to gently come out, I'm gonna use my left hand and gently place it by my left ear and guide my neck back up so that it's not doing any work, it's just gently drawing back up. And then just, I like to just do a little check-in, moving my head side to side. Did anything shift? Did anything change? And if it did, that's okay, it's just noticing. Pausing back in neutral, inhale, lengthen. And then exhale, drawing that right ear down to the right shoulder. Pause and notice. Notice how the left side feels. Maybe this is exactly where you need to stay, or inviting you to let that left arm start to hang. Taking that nice deep breath in through the nose. And as you exhale, feeling that shoulder just starting to let go, getting a little heavier. Taking that nice deep breath and maybe focusing that you're drawing that breath all the way through the neck. And as you exhale, see if you can let that shoulder blade drop down a little deeper. And then taking another nice breath in. And as you exhale, just feeling that whole side of the left neck and shoulder and arm is starting to let go. Maybe feeling a little tingling. And then gently using that right hand to help guide that head back into neutral. Giving yourself those little gentle turns side to side. And just notice. Beautiful, coming back to center. And then we're just gonna come into just a nice gentle twist. So I'm just gonna push my blocks out of the way, bring my feet down. I'm just gonna scooch my butt a little forward so I'm not quite as back towards that back. I'm gonna inhale, lengthen my spine. And then as I exhale, I'm gonna take my left hand to my right knee, and my right hand, I'm just gonna bring to the side of the chair, kind of at the back if it can go, but just being gentle as I'm exhaling. Inhale, lengthen, and maybe exhale, twist a little deeper, but pause where you need to, and just breathe. And then it's on an inhale where I'm gonna gently unwind and come back to center. So noticing how that felt, and maybe it's just a turn, maybe all you have is this. So listen to your body, taking it only where it feels like it can go today. And then I'm going to inhale, lengthen. And then on the exhale, placing that right hand onto left knee and drawing the body. So listen, if that feels like it's too much, coming out and just doing a little gentle twist. So it's almost like a turn, so we're not twisting. If you feel like you can have the twist, drawing the left hand back as we exhale, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, maybe twist a little deeper. Breathing and noticing, how does this feel? And then inhale, coming back to center. And just kind of, sometimes I like to just move around, see how that's landing. And then I'm gonna move down and just start to warm my hips up. So I'm gonna take my right ankle over my left knee, and I like to hold on to my right foot, just giving it a little hold so that I remember to activate my foot. So really pressing through that big toe ball mound, baby toe ball mound, just keeping it nice and active because that's gonna help protect my knee. And we're just gonna inhale, lengthen. And then as you exhale, if it's available, maybe this is a big enough hip stretch sitting up, but you can also gently lean forward. And just gently. So listening to the body, so that hinge is from the hip, finding where you feel the stretch and breathe. Just allowing yourself to feel that nice hip opening. And then inhale, rising up. Gently unwinding that foot, planting it down, just making sure we find that nice alignment, moving to the left side. And remember, each side of the body is different. So this side might feel a little tighter. Just listening to where you are, we're activating that foot, helping us protect our knee. So we're activating all of these muscles so that our knee is not in any danger. We want to inhale to lengthen. Exhale, gently hinge forward. And notice where you feel the stretch. Does it feel different than the right side? It's all information for you to be aware of as you start to move through the body. Beautiful. And then inhale, rising up. And gently unwinding that leg. And just letting them, sometimes I just like let them rock side to side, noticing if anything's kind of coming up for me, if it feels a little looser. So there's just gentle ways to warm the body up. And so thank you so much for joining. Those are just a few movements you can do in the chair. I just wanted to share a couple of things that we can do being seated in order to move through the shoulders, through the spine, through the hips, and allowing us to be able to move through just opening up the body. And I come back. And so I just want to say thank you for tuning in and just exploring a few movements in the chair. You can do a whole practice of yoga in the chair or standing and being supported by the chair. The chair is a way to enhance your practice. It doesn't mean that you're limited or unable to do yoga. I always look at it as a way to enhance your practice. It's a beautiful prop to use. Chair yoga can be used while you're at the office. Maybe you need to bring some movement in. You can't get up and walk around, but maybe moving your body in your chair where you're seated, and that can help create more wellness.